Smashing Pumpkins intended their new album to be a double album from the very outset. Speaking about their previous album, Billy Corgan said, "We almost had enough material to make Siamese Dream a double album. With this new album, I really like the notion that we would create a wider scope in which to put other kinds of material we were writing." Corgan described the album at the time as the wall for Generation X, a comparison with Pink Floyd's 1979 double album, one of the best-known concept albums of all time. The songs on the album hang together conceptually, with one half representing the day and the second half the night. Despite this, Corgan has rejected the idea that the album has a specific concept, but has said that the album is based on the human condition of mortal sorrow. Corgan aimed the album's message at people aged 14 to 24 years old. Guitarist James Iha and bassist Darcy Retzky played a much larger role in the recording of the album compared to previous albums. It's been rumored Billy Corgan recorded all the bass and guitar parts himself on past albums. James Iha compared about the recording process for Mellon Collie and the Infinite Sadness. "The big change is that Billy is not being into the big, I do this, I do that. It's much better. The band arranged a lot of songs for this record, and the songwriting process was organic. The circumstances of the last record and the way that we worked was really bad." The band recorded 57 completed songs throughout the recording process for the album. All of them were up for contention to be included on Mellon Collie. The album was originally going to have 32 songs, but this was cut back to 28 songs, split evenly with 14 songs on each disc. Mellon Collie and the Infinite Sadness debuted at number 1 on the Billboard 200 following its release on October 23, 1995. It went on to sell over 10 million copies in North America alone. Mellon Collie and the Infinite Sadness went on to earn 7 nominations at the 1997 Grammy Awards. Speaking to Rolling Stone magazine, Billy Corgan reflected on the album, saying, "We made something that was more about capturing the spirit of the times rather than worrying about making a perfect record. I never felt that Mellon Collie was perfect, but I think it's perfectly imperfect."